Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel, this is Jersey, and today we are gonna be working on our pier. Alright, so a little backstory. I was doing more research for our coastal town, right? Because my mind has been going crazy, it just been going in a lot of different directions lately. You know, I had my initial layout, I've been tweaking the layout, and now I wanted more, kind of more realistic, a little more back roads, a little more ways to get around. I don't want just one road, I want more roads, I want more kind of like areas and just that you go around and then you see more water, and I want to bring more water into places. So it's, I'm looking to like fishing villages, fishing docks, fishing area, very coastal, right? Where the water is very interactive with nature. So I was looking at all of that, right? I encountered this picture of this pier, and it was long, and it was beautiful, it was majestic, and that picture captured me, and I was like, I wanna build that. I need that for this coastal town. I think it's gonna be a magnificent build. It's not complicated, but it's gonna be gorgeous. And the main thing that I wanted on this build is I wanted it to feel like a pier, right? So what I did initially before we even started working, I was swimming in this area out, and I found this area where there's these rocks and there's all this coral, right? All around it. And it's deep and it looks beautiful. And then you can see all the ocean life. Look, right now we can see the jellyfish, we can see fish, you can see the coral, you see the plants. And it's just a nice view. And that's what I wanted for the pier. And the other thing that to make this pier even more stand out, right, is we're gonna have to level more of the sand. We gotta take all the sand away so we can make it more deep. And for that, we have a special guest star.
Hi, everyone.
So the other night we were actually together in the office, and I was telling her the story about the pier and the stuff that I was trying to do and running the idea by her.
Yeah, mm-hmm. We were both just kind of hanging out here in the office, and it was a little late and I was feeling a little tired, but I was like, you know what, let me just jump on the computer and I'll head on over to his island. And he's like, you know what, you can just help me just kind of move dirt. It's something simple, easy, but it was going to really help him get things moving along. I was like, yeah, that sounds great. So that's what we did for a little while, and then, you know, he was showing me the pier and stuff, but I know we're gonna talk about that in a minute or two.
Yeah, so when she was sitting here with me, I was just explaining the new pier idea, the pictures that I saw, and then the effect that I wanted to create. And the effect is, as we start working on the pier, I wanted to start looking that everything looks deeper, and as we go out into the pier, it's gonna look deeper in the ocean. So we needed to move a lot of this dirt. And that was something that I was gonna start doing, but she had some free time, and she's like, hey, let me just jump in over there, like she stated, and then she just came over and we started helping each other. And like I always talk about, having that another person to help you out sometime is such a great thing, because it's a lot of work. It's sometimes just little tasks like this, but for some reason she loves doing stuff like this.
And that's the thing, it's very simple, it's easy, it just takes time. And you know, when you have an extra set of hands, it just makes it go so much quicker, and I enjoy that. I like, you know, just helping out in his island just as I'm able to, as I can. You know, usually Jersa plays a little bit later on at night, once he gets home from work. I get home a little bit earlier, so every now and then I'm just like, you know what, I have some free time, let me jump on. But usually we're not playing at the same time. Sometimes we do, sometimes we don't. So that's why I don't always appear in every single, like in all the videos. But and it's just as I'm able to, like here and there. Like he plays a lot more than I do, which is totally fine. And I just like supporting him in that way and just being like, you know, I'm like, hey, what do you need? Or is there anything you need, you know, gathered, or, you know, materials? Or so I'll occasionally ask and just be like, hey, I think I'm gonna jump on tonight. What do you need? So.
Yeah, and that's how our teamwork has been working, is because, like I always say, for whatever reason, she doesn't like designing. and it works out great because I like designing. I like that aspect of Dinkum, right? The trying to be creative
the
or
creative
something.
Aspect.
And yeah. She finds gathering resources very relaxing. Like, mm-hmm. And but yeah, but that's how our teamwork has been working. I know we just introduced her logo. I know you guys love her when she's on video, and you guys love hearing her giving her opinion, and that's something that we may try, because if she's not on camera, she's just doing stuff off camera, but she is involved in a lot of the builds, because she's the first one that sees them, and sometimes I need a second pair of eyes
yeah.
to look, and then she's standing here in front of the computer for an hour because I just keep talking about, well, I can do this, or I can do this, or what do you think if I do that instead, or what about if I do this? I show her the pictures that I'm actually looking on real life, and trying to duplicate something that's in real life, bring it into Dinkum in the best way possible. And that's where her collaboration comes in a lot. A lot of it is off camera, and then a lot of it is visualization, just getting her input before I actually make it as a final build. And that's how we've been working. But the Pier idea, what do you think about the Pier?
I love it. I like you mentioned earlier, I just really like how, you know, it kind of brings you further out into the ocean, and you're able to see all of that ocean life, just the plants and the jellyfish and the fish. I really love that, because you don't get that same effect or that same feel like when you're just on the shore. I mean, the shore's great. I mean, that's part of the coastal town, but the Pier, it gives you that whole other experience and that other viewpoint, which I love. So I think it's coming out really great. I like it.
You saw in the background, the bird was chasing you.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh,
that was funny.
Oh, yeah.
That was funny.
Yeah, he came over to attack me, so I had to run away.
So one of the other things that is going to be great about the Pier is that when we are fishing, you know, we are going to be able to fish out here and see more of it. And I can't wait to see sharks. Like a lot closer, instead of just seeing them far away and you don't see them unless you have a jet ski or a boat, we'll be able to walk into the Pier. And that's the whole part of the build, right? It's just creating something. And another reason I wanted it in the entry of the coastal town, because I think it was gonna bring something extra to this beginning part of the town, but it's great. But here we are, we did a lot of work. We're gonna show the map, because now the map looks a little bit different for all the cleanup that we did. So now we're gonna see the effect on the water, and then Esther will be calling it a day for now.
Yeah, after a little while, I was ready to turn in for the night. So I was like, okay, I think I'm ready to head out, but I'm gonna just say bye for now, but I will be back very soon.
All right, well, like always, thank you so much and for being here and participating, and we'll see you next time.
Yeah, sounds great. See you next time.
All right, so now we are gonna be focusing on the details of the build. So what I wanted to make in this Pier, you know, to make it as real as possible as we can. When you look at piers online and you look at the pictures, usually they're very high above the water, right? Very high up, and then got those wood beams. Some of them are cement beams, and they're like legs, you know, it's what's holding the Pier up in the air. So I wanted to make something like that, right? So I was thinking, how can I make that illusion happen? So I was thinking I can make the same thing that I was making when we saw in the very first part of the Pier, you know, those little beams. But then I came up with the idea of doing it separate. Instead of doing a whole row of dirt, you know, and then doing every other one like I was doing, what if I truly just make a one every other, so then we can see more water in between. And then as we did that, it hit me, and I was like, okay, so now we can make those dark wood and use the dark wood, even though it's in the water and you not may be able to see it, but I know it's dark wood, and we give it that little bit of a tone. And then we put the pillars on top of it, and then the water's hitting the pillars. And then, and for me, I was creating that effect, because the water is hitting the pillars. We are seeing the dark wood like let's go ahead and call them like beams, you know, the beams holding that, and just kind of gives a little structure instead of just being plain and just around and just that. It just creates that a little bit of a depth, a little bit of a feel to it. So in some areas, didn't come out perfect as we're looking right here, right? It's because the rock. So I had to like kind of work around, okay, I can't put the beams where exactly I want it. So I had to play around with it until I found a way that aesthetically looked really good, because right there in that corner, I could not put it. And I don't want to break down the rock. The whole idea why I brought the pier to right here, to this level, is because I have this rock, that rock, two more rocks on the side. It looks all pretty. It's an area that when you're standing, it looks beautiful. And it was selected for that reason. And that's what I exactly wanted to do. So I had to keep playing around in such a way, into the point that for me, visually, it was pleasing to the eye. I have the right spacing between each one of them. And I was like, okay, this looks good. I can work with this because I'm not gonna break the rocks. If I wanted to be perfectionist, I should have broken down the rock, but I don't want to because they're beautiful. It's just that's something that I want to look. So here I was jumping, trying to put the pillars, and that's when I realized, wait, what if I make this dark wood? And I just changed it, instead of leaving them as dirt, put them as dark wood. And this is one of the ways that I was able to find the quickest way to put them in the, it was kind of jumping, and as you're jumping and falling, you can kind of place it down into the, but then I noticed that it somehow it does let me run with it. So I was able to run somehow, it's like walking on water, and able to at least put the dark panel very soon, like just all of them in a row. And that worked out great. It just was kind of nice to be able to do it and pick things up. But then for the pillars, I have to do it again. I had to like kind of jump, and as you're gonna fall, I'm just pressing the button, so when I'm falling, it just puts the pillar down. And that's the best way that I was able to find to actually do this without having like to either raise the level or lowering the level. But if for whatever reason you guys do find a better way to do this, let me know, because in the future I know I'm gonna do this again, and I wanna do it in an easier way. And if I find an easier way in the future, it'll be on video and we'll see it. But by doing this visually, like right here, it started taking shape. I'm like, okay, I like this. I like how we have those little details. It opens up more of the area. It makes the bill feel even bigger and more like, I don't know, I don't know the right word, but it just makes it feel more robust, maybe more like, this is a big bill. Look at all this detail. And then by putting the fence, once I finished putting the fence, that's when everything took shape, and I was very happy with the pier. And it just looked really good. The other thing is I did eventually work a little more off camera in between my lunch or break, because I went ahead and I started digging even more dirt out so I can make more areas more deeper as we go deeper into the pier, into the very end of the pier. And then right here, I saw a lot of pictures of beach area or coastal town area that have like this wall of cement that prevents kind of like the wave rushing in and destroying sand or coming in into the road, unless there's a big storm and then they go over that, right? But it's kind of, and I thought aesthetically it was such a good idea, so I went ahead and added it. And just now it gave it even more. So we got the fence, we got the hedges, we got sand, and then we have like that wall of stone holding the water in place so it doesn't destroy what you have in the coastal area. So now I wanted to do a little extra decorating right in the entry of the pier, just to make it a little bit more beautiful, right? Let's just beautify a little bit. And I kind of wanted to match a little bit to what I have on the other side of the street, where we're gonna enter and go to the parking lot. And basically what I did is, it's very simple. I just use a couple flowers. You use the green bushes just to make a little hallway. And then I wasn't feeling that little tile that I have right there. So I went ahead and made it the same thing, palm wood. So when you're walking from there on, it's all attached to the pier. And once I did that change, everything started feeling so much better. It started feeling really, really good. Right here, I was trying to see how benches will look, and I haven't decided if I want to go with this bench, I want to go with palm wood benches, so I'm going to leave that for when I start decorating this section, because I have already some ideas the way I want to decorate a little more heavily this area, because right now all we've been doing is just the layout. And now that I start doing this little decoration, I'm like, okay, I kind of want to put the chairs that I want, I want to put the light posts that I really want, and that's going to be more like another shorter video, kind of like this one, like a stand off video, instead of being such a build video. It's going to be more like a decorating the entry video, and I'm getting ready to do that. But right now this looks really good, and it started to look very elegant, kind of the way that I wanted. I just want a little more of an entryway as you come in, and looking at different more pier entry pictures. Some of them are very there's nothing on it, it's just the entry. Some of them are heavily decorated. So I went kind of with both. I went a little bit minimal and big. And here, showing more of the progress a little bit there, it was how more deep I have made the water, and it looks so much better, because now you see those beam on the side of the pier, it just starts looking really, really good. And the farther you go out to the pier, then it's really deep. I think I finally made it to go 4 deep down, so it just gets really dark, and then you can start seeing more of the map, and then the map start looking really cool, because then you see the two piers on the side. And yeah, so everything, it just started to coming out the way that I wanted. It was simple, but I think the pier will give it that touch that we want in the entry town. But guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to hit a like, subscribe if you want to see more videos, and we'll see you next time. All right, see you later. Bye.